Let's undo your chair.
It's fine.
Nice
and close. We want to make sure we can see you, right?
There. Can you see me now? Can you see me now?
I can see you all right.
But you have to move this and let me get more for my feet. Today we did two
paint videos. Well, we did a coloring video, now we're going to do a painting video. Your hair's pretty messy, kiddo. Why don't you try to get a little sideways on this? See if we can still see you on there. Alright, so tonight we are going to be doing this handprint flamingo.
It got smaller. Now what are we going to do now?
So you can use paint and stamp your hand on here, or we'll also show you how to do it with crayon or marker.
Or paint.
So whether you're using paint, crayons, markers, you're going to want a light blue and a dark blue if you have it, yellow, pink, and green.
And a dark green.
And a dark green, yes. Our dark green is too empty to pour it out, so we're just inside. But first, let me put my phone on silent because I should have did that already. You'll also want a wet wipe if you are using paint because your hand will get dirty. I'm just going to quickly send Elena to wash hers. So my hand is very big to be making a flamingo. So I'm just going to... No, after you paint it. Not now. So I'm just going to use Elena's hand on my painting as well. So first, we're going to trace her hand for the crayon picture on this one. So I'm going to use this darker color pink. That way you guys can see it better. And I will just turn it this way. It actually has to be the other hand. I don't see
this hand.
I don't see anybody in here yet that we were waiting for, so we'll try and take it a little slow. So you want to put it right here, just like that. Maybe put that pinky in a little bit. All right, now hold it nice and still. Don't tip the entire table over. So you're going to trace your handprint just like that onto the paper.
Then color it in pink.
Nope, that'll be after. We want to wait and see. We were waiting to see if Tamisha and Shia.
Which hand did you use for this? Billy's?
I used Levi's hand.
Because he's more gentle than Lily?
Yes. All right, so now, which hand did we need? This one?
Cause see?
You can use this one, but you'd have to put it this way. Which hand do you want to use? That one? That one? What are you doing? Well, not putting it up there. We're going to paint it. All right, we'll do that one. That one's easier for you to put up there.
Yeah.
All right, give me, you could give me your hand. Give me. This may tickle.
Is it seven yet?
Okay. 7:02. All right, let's see.
Turn
it around. I need the palm of your hand.
So what am I doing?
So if you're using paint, you're just gonna paint their whole hand pink. Make sure there's enough on there that it doesn't dry before you get to stamp it. If they're giggly and wiggly, even better. Fingers. More fingers. More fingers? Oh my gosh, how many fingers you got?
Five. Okay.
All right, ready? Now, hold it like this. And you're going to stamp it right there. Push down nice and good. You got it? Take it off. Pull it. There you go. All right, now you got to do one more because you need one for your own paper, right?
Doesn't she have to fill in those spaces?
Javen, go somewhere.
This is Mommy and Elena video.
Yeah.
Not Javen and Mommy.
We'll do a big kid craft video. Open your fingers.
Tomorrow, right?
Maybe not tomorrow.
After tomorrow?
Maybe Tuesday.
It's gonna
I don't even
Tuesday.
Know what day of the week is it.
Is
it
Saturday? Sunday, Saturday.
All right, now you got to stamp one on your paper the same way.
Right here?
Right in the middle. Go ahead. Push them down nice and good. Hey, Laurie. Hi, Irene. All right, pick them up. Pick it up. All right, go wash your hands.
That was better than that one.
So we've got her handprint for her picture and her handprint for my example, and then I have the crayon hand for anybody that is using crayons. So while she is washing her hand, I'm just going to color in the crayon hand. So this is what we're doing. Handprint flamingo.
Let's leave Levi's hand.
There is Levi's hand.
Who drew that? Yeah, you know I'm not
wearing pussy. Hey, don't dry those right now. You can't be over your wet hands.
Okay. Did you use soap? Yeah. Sweat them.
All right, so if you are just joining us and you want to catch up, you're making either a crayon hand or a painted handprint with your hand, with your thumb facing down. So you can use either hand, but your thumb should be facing down. Ready, Freddy?
Mommy, I love you.
I love you too. All right, here's your paintbrush.
Yay. What are we gonna do?
So I'm gonna draw it on the crayon one so you can see, and I'm gonna use the darker purple color so that it shows up better for everybody. So you're gonna make like a big letter S.
So like
kind of a little, just wait 1 second with the paint, okay? And you're gonna make a little circle right here. Like that's the head. And you're gonna make that letter S again down to the front of the body.
Okay.
So you can make it a little bigger. As long as you're using the same color crayon, like if you're using your same pink, you won't see any of these lines, so it won't matter. You have my lines because you can see that I am drawing it.
Now the paintbrush.
So you're gonna make that head.
Then the eyes, then the nose.
And fill it all in with your crayon. If you're painting, you're going to take your paintbrush, and you're going to figure out where you want to put your head, and you're going to make a circle. So you go ahead and do that. Make a circle where you want to put your head.
That's a big head. What do I do now? Make an S?
Yes. But wait, hold on. Let's see. Tamisha just came in. Let's see if Jackie wants to catch up. So if Jackie's going to do it with us, she's going to trace her hand with her thumb down and color it in with pink crayon. Trace and color with the same pink crayon. And then you'll follow this same rule to make a circle with your crayon where you want your head. So I just have this one done because we've been quickly switching back and forth from paint to crayon. So after you have your hand paint and your circle,
I did it.
You're going to make a letter S right down to the body. I didn't have enough paint on there. Backwards letter S. Right down. And then you're just going to make it a little bit thicker.
You're almost doing 1v1s on the corporate channel. Then you do 1v1. You don't want to waste your time doing 1v1 all the time. What do you gain? What do you gain for 1v1?
Whoa, Lena. You lost your head there, Charlie. You're going to have to make the circle of your head a little bit bigger.
That's it? Mm-hmm. So you're going to make the neck and then the head. I made it bigger than yours.
Yep. Alright, so I've got my head and my neck. And then I've got my head and my neck over here. So I will continue with the crayon side first. You're going to take a black crayon or a black marker. You're going to make a little eyeball. You wait for your paint step, yes. Little black eyeball with your crayon.
Then,
you know, start at the top of the head and make a triangle. No, can you sit so they can see?
Do I need to wet this?
No.
Yes, we do.
And you can go ahead and color in that nose.
What do I do now?
Just wait a second, please. While you also have the black, you're going to make a little feather on your flamingo's body. And then the legs, you can choose which direction you want your legs to face. So for my cartoon one, my crayon one, I'm going to put one leg coming out this way. And just bend it over like a number four. And one leg down this way. And color it in like a number four. Now you can put some little toes on there. Some little clothes on there. So that's your black step for your crayon or your marker. Now, we can just put these right in the cup and get a different brush. Here's one for you. Here's one for me.
You put.
So you're going to get a little bit of black.
They draw the four?
You're going to draw number four. So this one, I'm going to go this way with my leg. So we have two different, like go right out from your thumb. And then straight down with your other leg. And then you can paint some little toes. One, two, three. And one, two, three. Okay? Let me see. Good job. And very lightly make a little wing. And then a little triangle for the nose. So it'll go bloop,
bloop. Color it in.
And color it in. You're right. Okay. So that's it for the black. Nevaeh took my water cup, so I'm assuming it was not a water cup.
It was full of apple juice.
Well, I asked her to get me a cup of water, so that's what she gets for not listening. So we'll clean off our brush in here because we don't have a cup of water and this is old anyways. We can just drop them in. Get new brushes. Drop them in.
Then we can jump out the water and we'll have like a clean brush.
Right. So now we're going to do our sun.
I know color is yellow.
So in whichever corner of the paper you want.
Mommy, look at what I did.
It's alright, just do it on the other side. We're going to make a yellow sun.
Look, that one alien isolation on it. Okay.
And then don't forget to add some lines.
Here's a roll. Okay.
Yellow sun. So on our crayon side, because we've got to remember our crayon friends, right?
We need to wipe these, right?
I think it'll be good because yellow and green are the same color family. So we'll be okay.
At first we should use the dark green, then the light green, right?
Right. Alright, so we got our sun on our crayon side. Now, we're going to make some plants. So our green is too low to squirt some out, so we're going to stick our brush right in there. Is it dry out? How come it's not? Well, it's kind of dry. We might have to get a different green. So we're just going to make some big leafy shapes going right up the paper.
And that's fine.
This paint is kind of dried out, so... Well, you got a left on your brush. Yours should work. Let me try mine.
So make like a X looky thing.
Yep, just make some big leafy sticks. And if it doesn't work good, then we'll just use the light green right over it. Yep. Lots of leafy colors. Just go ahead and make some more grass and leaves. They're supposed to kind of look like plants, so just make all kinds of lines. Just like grass that grows out of the water. Darker ones and lighter ones and big ones and small ones. And then we can put our brush in the bottle. And I will do the leaves on the colored one.
No, I'm not finished yet.
You can do that. I'm just doing these leaves. So we just want to make some big triangle shapes like grass.
I have lots and lots of details.
Now we'll do some dark green. Jamin, don't be annoying while we're doing something. I shouldn't even have to tell you that. All right, so I got my grass. If your finger's wet like that, go rinse it in the sink. Don't try and stick it in a water bottle. She almost tipped over the whole water bottle trying to put her finger in there. Is anybody coloring or painting at home with us, or are you guys just all watching? Lana's doing a pretty good job. Lily's gibberishing. Sorry, we're just waiting for Elena to rinse her finger. Elena Jean, come on, what are you doing? Come on. Now we're gonna use a different brush. Mommy's brushes are gonna be dirty. And we're gonna do some dark blue water. So get a little bit of the dark blue paint. And you're gonna make a squiggly shape just like this. Don't touch the black though, skip over it. And back down the other side.
I don't have enough paint for that.
Put some over the green. It's okay. You just have more plants is all. But you kind of want to try and skip over the black, because if it's not dry, it'll smudge in your water.
I did. See?
Mm-hmm. And then fill it in.
It's okay to get a tiny bit on it, just a tiny bit. Because I was coloring that, so we got a tiny bit on it. Hey, it comes up my flamingo's toe!
That's okay.
And just a little.
So that's your water. If you want, you can swirl a little bit of the light blue in there to make it look more like water, where there's different colors in there. And the same with the crayons. Draw a little blue squiggle and fill it on in.
Now you've got to do the sky. You need a way to draw.
Draw some darker waves inside your water. My waves aren't too dark because I can't really push on this because I'll tip it over. So now we're going to do the clouds. So we still have blue on there. We're just going to try and mix it into the light blue a little bit so that our brushes are mostly only in the light blue. Not over there, over there. That's alright, that's fine. I like to paint on my shirt because it's my pajama shirt. So, if you want clouds, you're going to use your paintbrush to draw some clouds. So that when you paint your background, you're going to paint all of the background except your clouds. And you have to be very careful when you go around your flamingo. So you could just do some big zigzag shapes like this and not actually fill your background in completely. That way, you don't have to worry about getting
Mommy, I want to fill my clouds in. I want to fill my clouds in.
Well, then you're not going to have clouds. You can fill the whole background in, and then I'll give you some white to make clouds. How about that? So the same on your coloring picture. Draw your cloud shapes.
Do I put it in here?
Yes. And then I have a different color blue. If you don't, that's okay. And just fill in your sky all around your flamingo. Without coloring in those clouds. Don't forget in between your leaves. Okay, so my crayon picture is all done. Now I'm going to finish up my flamingo picture because I know that I can paint the background without making a mess. So I'm going to go right in.
I can.
Along all these fingers. And fill in my sky. You don't have to do this. If you don't want to fill it in all the way, you can just do those squiggles that I showed you. So right up to your flamingo's booty. And fill in all those blues. And we're just using paper. You don't need to use anything special. Thank you.
I do more than one.
Oh yeah, is this a race? Being shown up by the 6-year-old?
Hey, you used all the blue paint. Make sure you spread it.
Yep, spread it all around
the paper.
You could even, if you haven't started yet and you're planning on doing this later, you can even probably trace your hand and paint the rest of the background blue and then stamp your hand on and put all the details in so that you don't have to go in between everything later. Right? That would be a good idea.
Do you need to do it in the water? The black wasn't dried and I accidentally touched the black a tiny bit.
That's okay. Just put a little bit more glue over it.
No, I do not.
I'm almost done with my sky.
And don't you guys save the rest of the blue for me, okay?
I sure will. Over just a little bit because I'm running out of room. I got some glue on my leg too.
The legs are hard. Right?
Yep. But that's okay.
Mommy, look at mine.
Beautiful.
I'm almost done too. Mommy, do I need to eat dinner? Because downstairs I ate pizza.
That's okay. different. So I lost a little bit of my legs down here. I'm just going to fill them back in. I'm going to put a little more blue from my water here so that I have my wavy line back. And then I can wipe off my brush and use the same brush in the green. Oh, I'm almost out of green. I'll mix it in with the green that's there. Maybe a little more. Just to fill in my plants a little more. Because I did get some blue on top. Okay. And I'm gonna put my brush in the water.
I'm almost done, Mommy, look.
Yeah, and then I'm gonna grab a little more yellow and just brighten up those sunbeams.
I just need a couple more patches near the
Because I got a little close with my blue. So it's okay if you go over and you make a little bit of a mess, because you can just fill it right back in and fix it after. So this is my painted flamingo, and this is my crayon flamingo, and this is Elena Jean's flamingo. Did she do a good job? What do you think? I think she did an awesome job. Alright, so we are all done. I will keep the video up in case anybody else wants to follow along later. They can rewatch it. It only took us about 20 minutes, I think. Let's see. 32 minutes. Not so bad. Hope everybody has a great night. Thanks for watching. Elena, come say bye, quick. Come say bye. You ran away. What do you tell everybody?
Bye, Jason.
Thank you for watching
me and my mom's video.
You just kicked me in the head. Hit me in the head. Good night.